Alright everyone, welcome back to Fire Emblem. We're going to have a bit of a quiet episode today. And we're going to be starting chapter 11 here. To obtain the light sphere, Marth headed towards Thavis Tower. Hidden under the sands is the ancient city of Thavis, as well as many buried treasures. Legends of this illusioned city lured many men to the desert. However, nobody was ever able to make it back. The sage once said, "Don't go near the death desert of Marmatord, because there lies a city cursed by darkness." Well, what is going on here? Okay, so we're gonna need archers. Alright. We can deposit that. Give her a heal for now. I don't think he needs that anymore. I think his speed is maxed out. Okay, so we'll bring my healers. Oh wait, first let me Okay, you know what? No, I think we're good. Leave him behind because he's not going to be very mobile. Do I need a thief? Does not look like I need a thief. Check everyone's weapons. I really don't have a lot of weapons, do I? She's probably fine. God, and this place is... This is the Death Desert of Marmatord. There was a story about it in the Henri Saga. Preventing my path first was the Desert of Death, with its scorching sun and blazing sandstorms. Barbarians of the Sand Clan and soaring dragons roam. The illusion town was within sight, but I could only remain where I was standing. Really? So Henri once came here and all alone as well? That's right. King Henri began his travels here to obtain the divine sword Falchion. And that was so that he could rescue Princess Artemis. Although it won't be long, I would like to describe the legend of Henri. 100 years ago, the ruler of this continent, the Holy Kingdom of Arcadia, was destroyed by the Dragon Tribe. Humans were enslaved and lived each day in despair. Some people wielded weapons to fight back, but they couldn't defeat the Dragon Tribe, and many people died. Also, the humans' only hope, the Arcadia royal family, was wiped out, and so the world lost all hope. However, at that time, at a small city called Altea, it was discovered that the Princess of Arcadia was hiding there. The angered Delunian Empire sent soldiers to Altea, aiming to capture the princess. That princess, Artemis, was prepared to give up her own life to save the citizens. However, the citizens of Altea swore that, even if they were completely annihilated, they would protect the princess. Knowing that the princess was still alive, the citizens of Pallas gathered a liberation army and continued the fight against the Delunian Empire. The leader of the liberation army, Duke Cardus, fought with the royal shield given to him by Artemis. As a result, he received enormous support. Thanks to his efforts, the war finally began to become in their favor. But then the king of the Earth Dragons, Medius, finally moved out. The dark breath of Earth Dragons possessed horrendous destructive power and had the effect of halving the enemy's strength. Under such a dire situation, it was thought that Altea's resistance wasn't going to hold out. Then at that time, a sage appeared and told the people that at the Ice Dragon Shrine to the distant north was a sword blessed by the deities. With that sword, the Earth Dragons could be defeated, but it definitely wasn't an easy task to reach the temple. So Henri, to save his beloved Artemis, left on a journey to obtain the sword. Yes, that's right, but I think that's enough for today. We still have a long road ahead of us. Over there. Keep them clear of the archers. I didn't bring any archers. That was probably a mistake. Thank you. I'll finish it off. Just for experience, I don't really know what else to do with her. Once the archers are gone, then I can start moving my flying units in. Thank you. Dare you dodge.
Thank you.
some damage, huh? Assuming they can even hit. Thank you. First one. I didn't realize they're all gonna get in there. He's basically useless. He's too slow to do anything, really. Thank you. is this? Master Sword? Let them come to me. Once the archer and that berserker are gone, then I feel good about the rest of this. dude all about? Nice. Killed him in one hit. You can have that Master Sword, sir. You earned it. Kills. Just a regular ass flying dragon. Thank you. be easier. I do this. Treasure hidden here. Do this like this. There's a bunch of secret treasures here, but I'm trying to figure out how you get them. Okay. If I have her attack. Sorry if I'm wasting everyone's time here, but supposedly there's a bunch of treasures here, and I want to see if I can get them. Actually, I should check if there's anything important. I mean, it's nothing, like, super important, but they're, looks like, good items. Game Boy Advance version or whatever it is. I might have just wasted everyone's time. There's a secret shop here, actually. Hold on. I think I might have to do that. Because I do have money to spend. Alright, there we go. Bear with me a little longer here. One more trip and then we're done. Two silver swords. Okay, now I'm done. Marth, it's been a long time. It's me, Tiki. I really missed you. Huh, Tiki? You came here to meet us? That's right, you're with Godo right now. I haven't seen you for a while and you've grown. Have you been well? I've been really lonely. You didn't come to visit me. I'm sorry, but I hadn't forgotten about you, Tiki. I wanted to ask you to come to Altea after things had settled down. Marth, I love you.
Huh?
As if. I wouldn't say something like that.
Zane.
I'm really sorry, I couldn't help it after seeing that serious expression on your face. Sorry, don't be angry. I was ordered by Godo to wait here for you. While I was waiting, I got more and more angry, wondering why I had to do something so boring. So I thought I'd think of a prank to pull on you. But my Tiki impression was pretty good, wasn't it? Well, that's the anxious face. Okay, let's go. You want to meet Godo, right? Zane, how'd you know Godo? Who are you? Oh, that doesn't really matter. Oh, don't just stand there. Follow me. Marth followed Zane and continued heading directly north. There he faced walls of towering mountains, as well as sheer cliffs and deep valleys. that after passing countless mountains, suddenly a scorching heat surrounds everyone. Magma flowing like rivers and sounds of roaring block their passage. This is truly a fearful sight. Dragons, and we'll take them on in the next episode. I'm sorry I kind of wasted a lot of time on that last episode, but I was promised treasure, and I don't think there was actually treasure. If you guys like what you're seeing, like, comment, subscribe, tell your friends, and we'll have more Fire Emblem in the next one.